I'm telling you, Katie, if you don't come up with a better idea, they're going to fire you, and then there's nothing I can do for you.
Yes, Daniel, I understand. This quarantine's been hard, but I have no inspiration. I should be outside exploring some haunted victims or even some haunted houses, but no, instead I'm stuck here watching Netflix all day.
Why not go on a search? Find a place that gets your creative juices going, all groovy and such.
Oh, thank you, Daniel. I'll get right to it. Cecil Hotel? No, too many floors. I'm staying in the country. Chillingham Castle. It's in England, though it's 6 hours away. What? Historical website? Why isn't there anything here?
Blackwell Hall? Last known residents were in 1892, owned by Victor and Effie Blakewell, Baron and Baroness.
What? What in the... It is 1 in the morning. What do you want?
I found the place. It's perfect.
This hour? Tell me about it.
While the house began construction in 1765, though the project took over 12 years to finish. It was built for the Baron and Baroness, who retreated back to England when the American Revolution broke out. They had a son who married a Scottish woman and gave birth to the last known residents, Victor and Effie Blakewell. There were twins who were found dead beside each other in 1892. Since then, the only other residents would keep reporting problems with the house. Mirrors shattering, bookshelves falling, water running red, supernatural stuff. And here's the kicker. Whenever the residents would move away, they would end up dead or missing less than a month later.
So where's it located?
Shrewsbury.
Congratulations, darling. We're going on a trip.
Katie Lucille Allen, if you don't get your soon-to-be-fired ass out of bed, I will drag you to Shrewsbury myself.
Daniel, you bloody prick. Bloody hell, Daniel. You could have woken me up like a normal person. Okay, Katie. What do you need? Old house. That means no electricity. So we need batteries. Recharger box. Camera battery. Pencil. Paper. Notebook.
Get your hat.
Right. Okay, so I have a call with the landlord in half an hour. Hello?
Hello, is this Katie Allen?
Yes, speaking.
Henry Carter, I'm the caretaker of the Blakewell Hall. I know I'm calling early. Katie, please, beware the siblings. One of them is very territorial.
What do you mean, siblings?
Oh,
Jesus.
Whoa, you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just had a really weird dream.
Don't worry, it was probably nothing. Katie, wake up. We're almost there.
Yes, that is I.
Katie, it's good to see you. We're glad to finally have somebody else staying at the house again.
We have the keys for you here as well.
Thank you.
And I do have a couple of things to note. The house does not currently have any power. However, there is a generator in the attic that you feel free to use at any point in time. And if you would like some sort of cellular service, you'll have to go to the attic as well. I understand you also have concerns about the pantry and the shortage, and I'd be lovely to come by on any Wednesdays or Sundays and, you know, always bring your groceries by for you. This is the house. It's a
one more thing before you do that. Please do be careful. The house is very old, obviously, and it can be a little dangerous.
Looks like someone new has come to visit us, Victor. Shall we give them a little scare?
No, Effie. Leave them be.
Are you okay with me just leaving them here?
No, don't worry about it. Me, yeah, I'll be fine.
How long are you planning on staying?
Around 2 weeks, around there. Oh, do you mind helping me unpack?
As long as there's music.
All right.
Well, I wonder, what room would you possibly choose?
This one here.
The room is beautiful. It's perfect and fits you well. Good choice.
I think I'll set up my typewriter downstairs so I'm not stuck here all day.
Good plan.
Saved you that day. Wrong place at the wrong time, people tell me. But sometimes you can't help but think it was an intentional hit. In your absence, I was taken in by a set of twins, Victor and Effie Blakewell, sole surviving heirs of the Blakewell name. They lived in this grand manor where it seems gloomy, but I can't help but feel at home as the twins fill the house with love. Either way, my loving father, I shall send you another letter soon.
Last night, it's just that I have to work today, and I didn't want to be late to work.
Oh, don't worry about me. When are you visiting
next? I know we didn't figure out on the phone last night, but we need to figure out how we're going to contact each other. Would it be easy if I came up and visit you on weekends?
Oh, that sounds awesome.
Well, I'm heading home now. I prefer to get home before it gets dark.
Oh, that's fine. Don't worry about it. Well, I hope you get enough rest, and contact me whenever you want to. She found my letters.
I saw that. What do you think she's doing here?
I don't know. She's confusing me. The way she dressed is different. And the music that she listens to. She's nothing like us.
Florence! Where do you think you're going?
I just need to get a better look.
You don't.
Her. Have you seen Effie? This girl could be in danger.
I was talking to her the day the girl arrived here, though I haven't seen her since.
What?
I heard music ringing out this afternoon. Was that you?
No.
What do you mean?
It was me.
My dear sister, what have you done?
Whatever do you mean, dear brother? She's an unwelcome guest in our house. I was only showing her who it belongs to.
done nothing to harm you. You will do well not to harm her.
Whatever could I do? I'm dead after all.
Katie, are you alright? What happened? Why are you laying on the floor of the bathroom with the water still going? Did you pass out?
Dear Lord, I'm sorry, Mr. Carter. Last night, I saw a figure going towards the bathroom. I went to investigate, and then the lights went out, and then there was blood in the bathtub.
All right.
When they came back on, there was blood in the bath.
Katie, there's no blood. Is everything okay? Dear Miss Allen, you seemed a bit stressed tonight. How about you go and get dressed, and I'll make you a nice cup of tea.
I would appreciate that. Thank you. I won't be long.
I must say, dude, you're not the only one who's seen things here. People say that this house is haunted, though me personally, I've never seen anything abnormal or paranormal here, but it may be attributed to the fact that I've never actually stayed a night here.
That's not the only thing. Yesterday afternoon, I was wandering the house and sat down in the study room, and then three books fell off of the shelf with a letter.
I'm not aware of how much studying you've done on this house already, but apparently the previous two owners actually experienced a lot of paranormal activity as well.
Yes, I read about that. The last owners were Mr. and Mrs. Blackwood?
Yes, the Blackwoods.
They moved out in 1956. Am I right? When did you get the house?
That would be correct. My father bought the house back in 1984 at an auction. And until then, it was just abandoned as far as I know, just collecting dust under the white sheets on the furniture. So, how's your book coming along? What type of book is it anyways? A more mystery, thriller, horror, romantic?
Well, I'm writing a story, a novel, a horror novel. And the thing is that it all depends on the history. It could be romantic, thriller, or even historical.
I just remembered, I have a bunch of old documents and books from the history of this house, so I can actually go find those for you. I'll be right back. Favorite hat while I was looking in the car. I found a bunch of stuff that you can probably use for your writing as well. Some blueprints, some
old diaries and books, some letters and whatnot, photos.
Oh, thank you.
Now, I do much apologize for the inconvenience, but I've got to get running now. I have plenty of stuff to do today, and I'm a very busy man, but I will be back with your groceries tomorrow, so you can always call me if you need anything.
That's quite all right. Thank you.
Thanks. You have a good day. Katie, one more thing. Sorry to bother, but one last thing. With all this talk of horror and whatnot, if you were interested, I could maybe show you where Effie and Victor's bodies were found.
What? Where they died?
Yes, but I am in quite a hurry, so it will have to be quickly and then I'll have to rush off.
Of course, I understand.
Perfect.
Don't want to take too much of your time.
Tends to do something to people. I'm off.
Florence, who are you and why are you never mentioned?